Now, Hillary, spring is under a month away.
Hurrah.
We all know what that means. You got your flowers, of course, your bees, warmer weather. You got to fill the gas bottle in the barbecue. That is most important. And the great spring clean.
All of the things. But did you know many of your major appliances could benefit from a bit of a once-over too? Lucas de Jong called in an expert to tell us how.
It's almost time, New Zealand. Grab your wipes, vacuums and mops and get cleaning. Some things, though, they get ignored in the Great Spring Spruce-Up. Thankfully, with 25 years in the industry, Ben from Apple Appliances has experience in all sorts of whiteware maintenance.
Wash machines, dishwashers, dryers, fridges, freezers, ovens, cooktops.
And today, he's got a few hints about heat pumps.
First thing is to keep the filters clean. If it's not working too well, the filters are probably blocked. In this case, just lift the flap up and pull the filters out. You can clean it out with a vacuum cleaner or a soft cloth, a little bit of mild detergent.
And good old dishwashing liquid will do.
If you haven't been looking after them, then it might need a professional to come around and clean the coils.
In the kitchen, the fridge can benefit from a good wipe.
Mainly your door seals, so if you've got food and stuff spilt on them, you need to clean them when it happens. If it's left to sit, the rubber rots and then they split and you'll need to replace them.
The rest just needs a once-over, but avoid anything too harsh.
Dishwashing liquid, warm water and either a soft cloth or a sponge. You're not meant to use anything like spray and wipe or any chemicals. It'll wreck it. They put a sticker on there to help you out.
And then it's the dishwasher.
Dishwashers are not waste disposals. You need to rinse your dishes. If you don't, then you'll often find that the filters are a bit grubby, plus the potential for blocking the pump is quite high, and you've got food scraps in here. Yes, you're meant to clean your filters regularly, again, maybe once a month. If you're not rinsing properly, you'll get blocked jets as well.
So click them off, get a toothpick in those holes, and empty them out. Also, do away with those fancy dishwasher cleaners.
They pretty much clean themselves, bar the filter. There's no point really using the economy or the fast or the quick washers all the time because you're not getting the best performance out of the dishwasher. The best way to do that is the full wash cycle with a quality detergent.
They're also good for cleaning other items, like your range hood.
So you can pop those out. They will fill up with grease, that's what they're there for. If you don't mind them being a bit dull, you can put them in the dishwasher, but I'd recommend not using any detergent. Run a really hot cycle. You just gotta dissolve that fat.
Downstairs, our last appliance is the washing machine.
Because you've got a front loader, then there is a filter, and that's the beauty of a front loader is you often have a filter that you can clean and prevent blockages in the pump. So you can generally open that up. A little shallow baking tray or something similar is a good idea. Clear any water that's in there. And once that water's stopped flowing, you can undo the pump filter. And there you go, you've got a blockage. You want to do that once a month. So if you're not cleaning it regularly enough, you can actually stop the machine from operating. A blocked pump, it won't spin, it won't drain.
Ben's biggest tip, however, is a pretty simple one.
Not enough people read the manual. It's the best thing to know what your machine needs and how to keep it healthy.
Do all that and your appliances will enjoy the warmer seasons as much as you. Roll on, summer!